In today's second installment of our series of three videos on four mallet grips, we take a look at the Stevens grip, or the Leigh-Stevens grip, or the Musser-Stevens grip, or the whatever the heck you want to call this grip. This grip was developed in the 1970s by Lee Howard Stevens as an extension of the Musser grip, which is why there's so many different odd names for it. This grip has a lot of benefits. It has the widest natural range of the grips we're looking at in this series, and it offers the most control. The one downside is that it's harder to do correctly than the other grips, and so it takes a little more practice. But after you get the hang of it, this is a very natural feeling grip. Grab one mallet at the very end of its shaft with the ring and pinky finger. This will be the outside mallet. Place the tip of the back end of the second mallet in the center of the palm. Hold this mallet with the tip of the middle finger. My instructor used to call this Spider-Manning because you look like Spider-Man reaching for his web shooter. Curl the index finger until the mallet sits in the crook at the first joint. Place the thumb on top of the mallet parallel to the shaft. Turn your wrist so that your thumbnail faces the ceiling. At first, your inside mallet will most likely pop up higher than the outside mallet. You want the inside mallet to hang down and to be at the same level as the outside mallet, or even slightly lower. To achieve this, let your index finger stick out past your middle finger as opposed to sit on top of it. It's okay if the inside mallet feels loose in your hand or like it wants to fall out. To widen the interval, always change the inside mallet, not the outside. To do this, simply point towards the inside and roll the mallet so it rotates down your finger to the desired length. For extra wide intervals, slip your thumb to the inside of your grip and push out. To change the inside note, changing the interval is fine. To change the outside note, always move your arm to accommodate the change. Trying to reach with the outside mallet can lead to damage in your tendons. Your fingers were not designed to move that way. Use a piston motion straight up and down to execute a stroke with this grip. This hand position also allows for easy execution of a ripple roll, as well as a hand-to-hand roll. I think at this point it's no surprise that this is my favorite of the four mallet grips. It's worth learning and teaching your students. It takes a little more attention to detail, but in the long run it's really worth it. Go to our website, musiciansnotepad.com/4mallets, to get this handout on the Stevens grip, to give to your students or to put up in your studio or classroom. There you will also find our video and handout for the traditional cross grip, and if the video that you're watching right now is more than 2 weeks old, you'll also see our video and handout on the Burton grip. In fact, the third Wednesday of every month, we release a free publication designed to help you help your percussion students. So make sure to go there, check out what we've got, and come back often, as well as like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. Let's hit it.